KCTK Radio proudly presents The Week Review.
Hey, you know what, guys? This right here, this rambling, boring conversation containing already made before observations, this could be a podcast.
It's actually not a bad idea.
Really? A podcast? Don't you have to be some sort of whiz kid to do those?
Definitely not. Anyone with a computer can make one.
Well, that's it. We're anyone. Let's do a podcast from right here in the booth. Who's in?
Yeah, sure.
Let's do it.
Is it happening? Are we doing it now?
Awesome.
You're the reason that we do what we do. Music and talk, it's all for you. Now the guys who are lots of fun for making you laugh, they're number one. They review the week just for you. So get ready for Paul and Drew.
Welcome to KCTK Radio's Week Review with Paul and Drew and Jack all up in your face. Join in on the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060. We dare you.
Welcome to KCTK Radio's Week Review with Paul and Drew and Jack. I'm Drew. Wait, no, I'm Paul. That's Drew and that's Jack. I think I just wanted to be Drew for a second. This is the show where we talk about things from last week and the things that may happen next week. And we've already started off with our first error. Isn't that great? Those of you counting at home, that's number one. You can join the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060. We welcome your participation. We broadcast live every Thursday night at 7 p.m. As you know, you can listen to us on live streaming at www.kctk.radio12345.com, but it is much easier to use the Listen to My Radio app on your phone. Also, you can watch all the past adventures on YouTube at the KCTK Radio channel and enjoy it because we're good-looking people. But that's not all. This program is offered as a podcast on iTunes, Podbean, and anywhere you get your favorite podcast. So, on with the show. Welcome, Drew.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's the Droosh, a.k.a. Night, a.k.a. Day.
Yeah, is night and day.
Are you okay?
Ooh. Yeah, I'm fine.
Nothing. You're supposed to be screaming six octaves louder.
Yeah.
And also, welcome to the show, Jack.
Yo.
Who is all up in your face, evidently. How are you, Jack?
I'm great.
Yeah, you're...
I graduate in a week.
Yeah. Have you guys both kind of been vaping or something? You guys are pretty laid back.
Yeah. No, I don't vape, unlike this guy. Drew's adopted vaping.
Excellent. Well, yeah. That's great.
And I told him to. and he took my advice.
That's really
and
wonderful.
And he loves it. That's what matters.
So any report on, on the prom, on the graduation?
Oh, prom? Prom is great. Fun fact, I got my new car. Got a 2010 Ford Fusion.
I sold
the truck and the computer. I'm pretty sure I said that last week. Sorry. Oh, I'm graduating high school with the highest GPA I've ever had. So.
Well, we got a new puppy. Our family did. And our puppy's named Blue.
Aww. I met this guy. I party with this guy, Robert DeLong.
Really?
Yeah. Crazy story. Oh, this isn't Robert DeLong. This is Robert DeLong.
Who'd you think it was?
I thought it was Robert DeLong.
It is.
Okay, yeah. Cool.
Yeah, Robert.
But now my favorite color is blue, but now my favorite song is this because he's friends with the Droosh.
Yeah. I met the guy.
Yeah.
Where'd you meet him? Tell the story.
Okay, so I went to see a concert at P&L. It was a free concert. It was
That's Power and Light, folks. That's Power and Light.
Power and Light. So it was gym class. It was Middle Class Rut, Robert DeLong, and I can't remember what the other band's name is.
This is Robert DeLong, right?
Right. So Robert DeLong went up actually right after Middle Class Rut. Awesome show. So anyway, we went there for a friend's birthday. We went to Maker's Mark. That's not there anymore. It got shut down. We went there. This is, by the way, the only coolest thing my friend Brian's ever done, in my opinion.
Who's Brian?
Chili.
Oh, okay.
Chili.
Right. This is the only cool thing I think he's ever done. So anyway, we're partying it up, everything like that. Robert DeLong does his set, goes over and starts autographing. My friend Chili is completely wasted.
Yes. Okay. So I do know who.
So next thing you know, we're all standing around. He rolls over the brick wall, comes back, goes all the way over to Robert Long, tells him, "Hey, come here." And the guy, Robert, thought he was security.
Oh, wow.
So he immediately got up and starts following my friend Chili. Chili brings him to the party.
Far out.
And we all just started partying with him, got pictures with him and stuff.
What does he look like?
He's a pretty short dude, blonde hair. He usually has like a symbol right here that he paints on his face before every like show.
Huh.
And it's also the same symbol of like his brand.
He sounds like Imagine Dragons.
It's pretty cool because the guy, I talked to him about his process. So what he does is he takes video game controllers, puts them in through a synthesizer with his laptop, and sits in his closet and just makes music like
by
with a board
buttons.
Like a board like that too.
Wow.
And also, and he also brings it in the concert. Like he'll sit there and do like a like an Xbox controller or something.
Huh.
One time he had a Wii thing, he was just doing one of these and something came on behind him. It was just, dude's great.
Wow.
I mean, it was great.
Well,
but nice guy. It was really cool meeting him.
I'm glad that he had a song where I can incorporate and think about my new puppy.
Wait, hold on. What was Chili wearing? What made him think? Was he wearing?
I don't remember what he was wearing, but I mean, it was just hilarious because he just said, "Get up and come follow me." And then Robert got up and followed him.
And when he was doing that, was he like meeting fans and stuff?
Yeah, I mean, people were high-fiving him and stuff as he walked past, but like that was it. And he just rolled over the wall with him. I mean, the restaurant didn't have a problem with it at all. I mean, he's Robert DeLong that just immediately let him in. And, my first question to him, though, because I'm wearing my Flash t-shirt.
Okay.
I looked at him. I was like, I'm going to decide if you're cool or not. Okay.
Oh, you're going to decide. Okay.
I'm going to decide. And I was like, Batman or Superman?
What did he say?
He took a minute.
Oh.
Okay. That's fair.
That's fair.
That's a good.
He's like, Batman. And I was like, here's a shot.
You know what? I can't. You know what? The real cool is Batman, Spider-Man.
Oh, that's a good one.
That's the real determining factor.
They've already proven in this one death match
simulation. Why? Because Batman and Superman are friends.
Right.
You know, you can't.
Yeah. No, unless you go to Dark Knight Returns.
No, you can't do that.
He still doesn't kill him.
You guys aren't listening, but you can't do Batman versus Spider-Man because they're different franchises. You got to have a
Yeah, but I have a comic book where
the
they meet.
That's the point.
I have a comic book where they meet.
That's why you ask, because they're different franchises.
Yeah, but I don't see Spider-Man in the MCU walking over to Gotham City going, "Hey, Batman, I missed you."
In the crossover, they figured out who killed Spider-Man's parents. Did you know who did that?
Was it the Joker?
Yep.
Oh, yeah!
Yep.
I'm so smart!
Yep.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah. Wait, so that's like a real thing? Is that confirmed canon, or is that just, hey, look at this cute crossover that we're doing?
It's probably something like cross-canon, but it's old
stuff. Can we go back to my puppy?
Yeah. Sorry, go ahead. I took it away.
It's Clues, Blues Clues.
Anyway, the puppy was named Rhapsody in Blue. They just named it when it was born, so we're keeping Blue.
I like it.
Oh, no. Let me take it back. It's because Keith called in, sixth caller, and said Blue.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Way to backtrack.
Yeah. Okay. But no one cares about this. In fact, we learned about Robert DeLong.
Oh, I know what we care about.
What?
Nothing, except for this guy.
And in a way, because of the Robert DeLong story, we have extra news from the Droosh. This is extra Drooshy tonight.
So I wanted to take a minute and not talk about news.
Oh.
I wanted to ask you guys.
You know what? This is your time. This is your time to shine. This is the forum.
I want to make this a forum, and I want to talk about something.
Okay.
When do you think the world went to shit?
Okay. When do I think the world went to shit?
I know.
And why?
March 22nd, 1968.
Let's see if that's correct.
Why? Oh, that is terrific. I want to know why.
No, truth be told, the world went to shit.
Here's the thing that really upsets
me. I'm a dumb kid and I don't really know much about history, so I can't really give a good answer, but you know what? I'm going to say that whenever North Korea became a thing.
North Korea has been a thing for a long time, man, since
whenever,
the Korean War.
Well, guess what? When it became a thing, that's when.
Okay.
Well, I'm sitting here. I'm kind of really mad right now.
Why? Did I bring up something that's bad?
No, because when things went to shit, I was about to say May 11th, 2000. But Jack beat me to the joke, and I'm very angry about it.
Woo!
I'm very angry about it, so congratulations.
Thank you.
You know what? What really, where everything went to shit was in the 1980s, and it went to shit because Reagan was a phony baloney actor acting like he was a conservative guy, and they got rid of a thing called the Fairness Doctrine. That's when all the media became for profit as opposed to just being balanced. And that's, my friends, that's when everything went wrong.
See, now, I was thinking about this today.
Mm-hmm. Were you thinking something like when women got the right to vote or something?
No, nothing like that. I'm not sexist or racist.
Now, is that the type of answer you're looking for?
No, yeah. I'm looking for an opinion. Because I was just... I sit there and I listen to the news every day in my in my customer's car or a PDI. Which is a brand new car that you have to get ready for sale.
Because I had a PDI one time and got some penicillin. And
it cleared it right up. Right. Yeah. It did sting a little bit.
It did.
Yeah, it's fine.
I don't know what you guys are talking about. You guys are old people doing old people things.
Right. You know, sometimes I just drink cranberry juice and I was fine.
Oh, that works. Yeah.
So anyway, I was starting to think, because every news that comes out these days is fucking tragic. Like the New Jersey thing today.
Dude, you know why?
What happened in New Jersey?
Okay, so today in New Jersey, a school bus got in a wreck. 40 people were hurt. 2 people are dead.
Yeah.
And then you have that thing in Israel.
Yeah.
I mean, nothing's happy.
Dude, this guy's tearing up right now talking about this.
Well, there's always been car wrecks. There's a lot less car wrecks than there were. And the reason is because
Tesla's reinventing the world.
No, because they have put regulations on roads, on seatbelts, on the type of cars we drive. It's so dramatic how many people don't really die when we drive.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
What?
It's truth.
You say that like as if more people should die.
No, because they used to.
Yeah, you get in a car accident, that'd be it.
Right, and now nowadays people, they can find, particularly breast cancer, but other kind of cancer, quicker than they used to.
Yeah.
It seems like more people have it because they can find it more.
Right.
But the problem is that we're all, because of the Fairness Doctrine going away, we're all watching this media, and they are so biased to want them to watch them.
Right.
And it's sensational. It's, this is scary, this is scary, this is scary. And that's... is freaking everybody out.
Yeah.
And we have leadership in our country who has just knows how to work this deal.
Yeah.
They know how to work it and work it and work it.
It's going to be huge.
Yeah.
You want to know an idea that I had that would fix a lot of car accidents and
this is gonna be
people
good.
Getting blamed? You know how they have those black boxes for airplanes?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
They need to make those for cars. And whenever there's a moment of impact, the box should write down your exact speed, volume of your radio, freaking where the position that your steering wheel was in, where your tires were, all these other things. So you can see if somebody was fucking up. Just
what
saying.
You just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard.
Hey, man, don't beat on my idea. That's a good idea.
Are you
in no way, shape, or form?
Wait a minute. Are you... do you know the... it's an old Seinfeld joke. Is that what you're doing? Are you doing shtick?
Yeah.
His Seinfeld's joke is, what's the deal with the black box? Won't they make the whole plane out of the black box?
Because it doesn't get destroyed.
I'd like to know. Pretty good, huh?
Yeah, that's pretty good.
So I think you're right, Jack. I think there's going to be something. And I think, you know those things? Do you guys put those things in there for your insurance company?
No, like the progressive thing?
Yeah.
No.
Those kind of do that. They tell you when you're how fast you're going and if you're going too much. I had to get rid of mine. What's the deal with airline food? Is it edible or not?
No grapes, no nuts.
What's the deal? Thanks, Jack.
You're welcome. I thought you needed that.
I appreciate it.
Bow, 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 bow,
I have bow. a whole thing that you're going to start using. Okay.
Can I put Seinfeld on there?
Yeah. So, do you have a point? Do you have? When do you feel like just in your life when it,
in my
it
life,
flipped over?
In my lifetime, I felt like everything was fine until 2008.
Okay.
What happened to that? Obama got elected.
Because you think Obama got elected?
Wow.
No.
Are you a racist?
No.
Wow.
Our house got taken. The economy crashed. My house got taken by the bank. My parents got divorced.
It's kind of racist and everything like that.
It wasn't a good year.
You know what?
You know, you're making this really, this whole podcast really negative
you're,
at the moment.
I'm not making it negative. I really was asking a question. You asked why, what, when do I think it went to shit? Then you wanted to give me a racist joke that I'm being racist.
Let me back you up here for a second.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's when the economy went crap.
Right. I'm not blaming Obama for it.
The only other time, well, he fixed it.
Right.
The only other time it was worse was the Great Depression.
Right.
And now people remember that and are freaked out. And everyone is like, I want mine. I don't want to give you higher wages. I want to do this.
Yeah.
And we're all separated. And
don't worry.
I think you're right. I think that was a big dividing point of fear.
And I just noticed it at my work that, like, people are treated more like shit lately. Mm-hmm. And it's just, it doesn't seem to feel.
Because they're fearful that perhaps, to go along with the theory, that the economy will break again and they'll be out with
right. Yeah, but we got World War III coming in like a couple of years. I figured
dude, we're already in World War III. It's just secret.
And yeah, well, then why isn't the economy getting fixed?
It's just shadow war.
Because war fixes the economy.
Well, and it's all drone shit.
The economy's good. It's just that wages aren't rising. So
yeah, and our enemy is terrorism. That's everybody's focused on terrorism. So technically, yeah. We're in World War III already.
Eh.
We've been in a war for 15 years, for God's sakes.
I think
go ahead. Go ahead, Kermit. You evidently have something to say.
Yeah, I think it went bad when they got rid of Alpo. It's my favorite food. And everything like that.
Yeah, Alpo. Gotcha. Totally hear you.
Were you having trouble hearing him?
No, I was fine. Did you?
Don't worry, Kermit. You're good. Don't worry. You're fine.
Thanks, Jack, and everything like that.
I love you, Kermit. I just want you to know that.
Fuck you.
So that, any other news from the Druge?
Not till later, but
okay.
You know.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
Every, and I'm paraphrasing, I'm kind of imagining the quote I don't remember exactly from Bill Clinton. He was our president.
Right.
Every problem that we have, we can solve.
Right.
Something along those lines. So be positive.
Okay.
Be positive.
Right.
We need a lot more positivity. That's
Believe
why
me, I'm trying to stay
hey,
positive.
That's why I played all the positive songs.
Right.
No one... I remember playing it and then asking, you know, the listeners, hey, what do you guys think of this? You know, what's your thoughts on this type of music? And
then
what,
Julie calls... Drunk Julie calls in.
And this is... I have a tape response of it. You know, I'm just doing my part.
That's a good one.
But you know what will also get us out of some of this and make us a little bit more positive?
Jack's Tech News!
Is some tech talk, some technology.
What do you got today?
Actually, your tech news won't, but maybe the technology will.
So I'm going to kind of change some things up here. I'm not going to talk about Pied Piper. They're doing fine.
Are they?
Okay, they're fine. Their coin value is going up. That's it.
Okay, wait.
Oh, shit.
Did they have a season finale?
They did have a season finale.
I didn't watch it yet.
Oh, you gotta watch it. It's okay. So good. Okay. Here's kind of some uplifting things, kind of like the opposite of Drew.
Cool.
cool. So, you know, there's...
Hi, guys. It's me, Eeyore.
Hey, guys.
It's me, Drush.
This is Drush. And Microsoft is doing a good thing.
Okay.
There's disabled people out there who always want to play.
What the fuck are you doing?
The
you
microphone.
Like, this isn't your boyfriend's dick. Get it away from your face.
No. Inappropriate. Okay, anyway.
No, Microsoft is making a controller. It's going to be the first come over Sony to make a controller that disabled people can play video games now.
How?
It's like a little pad that has like turning things on it, and you can customize them to be whatever you want, but it's easier for disabled people to actually play video games, which... I mean, yes, you can get. There's been third party accessories to be able to do that. But Microsoft's actually doing it themselves now. They're making their own thing. Make sure that whatever disabilities you got, you'll be able to play your video
games.
That's
cool.
Yeah.
Will I be able to play Fortnite on this laptop here?
No.
Wait, you play Fortnite?
No, play Fortnite.
I want to, but Jack said you can't. Your laptop's not good enough.
You need to
buy a $1,000 laptop.
Another thing that happened. Oh, the internet broke today because Call of Duty Black Ops 4 got announced, and it looks amazing.
Okay.
They're having their own battle royale mode, which is kind of like Fortnite, except they have millions of dollars for a budget, so it's going to be really good. Hopefully.
What can I play that on this computer? You think?
No.
Okay.
And, you know, nothing else is really going on, so that's pretty much it.
You know what's really sad is today I thought for sure you're going to talk about the net neutrality thing that got passed.
Yeah, you know, did you hear that news?
You know, I did not.
I thought for sure that had been tech news.
Dude, I sold my computer. You know, I'm kind of out now of the
Go ahead, Drew.
I got God of War.
Drew, hey, yeah. Do you know anything about God of War yet?
I've played all the God of Wars.
But have you like have you heard anything about before? Like, do you know how it ends and stuff like that? The God of War.
Yeah,
Drew, give us the news on.
Okay, so net neutrality, right? They passed it to where they, you know, you don't have to pay right now. So it's been continued.
Yeah.
So awesome for us, but you know they're still trying to pressure into having net neutrality. But it's been dismantled for a while.
I tell you what, I am amazed by that because the FCC wanted to get rid of it,
nope.
And then people
Ajit Pai wanted to get rid of it.
Well, they all voted. He's the chair, and they voted to get rid of it.
He's the one who got millions of dollars from Verizon to make the idea.
I know, and he led the FCC to vote to get rid of it.
He's a freaking douchebag, and now he's a giant clown on the internet. Look at memes about him; it's hilarious.
And here's what happened: people got mad. They contacted the Congress, and the Congress actually listened to people.
Yeah.
There's hope right there. There really is.
You know what else is hope?
What?
I'll say this: McCain gave me some hope the other day.
What'd he do?
He's like, I don't want the president being at my funeral. And everybody was so pissed, and I was like, why? It's his funeral. If I don't want somebody there, I wouldn't want them there either. And not to mention, you heard what that Sadler, is it a woman who said it, or is it some, I don't remember who it was, but they said, well, he's dying anyway, so what does it matter?
Yeah. Adam Sadler said that?
I hope the president feels good about that. Actually, I hope he feels terrible about that. He thinks
I hope he feels terrible because McCain's actually, you know, level-headed. He's actually not a bad dude.
Wow. Well, I wanted to tell you guys about some things.
Okay.
There are some true facts.
I was going to do facts today, too.
True facts, but they just happened to sound wrong.
Oh, let's hear it.
No, wait. Let me set this up better. True facts that completely sound made up.
Okay.
Okay, tell me if you guys have heard these before. Possums are basically immune to snake venom.
I can believe that.
So the snake venom...
Like a mongoose?
No, a possum. Have you ever seen the possums?
Yeah, I know that, but I'm just asking because, like, there's, like, a honey badgers and stuff like that. They seem to be immune to, like, cobra venom.
Well, yeah, so it makes sense to you.
I mean, that could possibly be true, but he's just talking about possums in general.
No, I got you. I was just asking. My bad.
Okay. The McRib contains over 50 ingredients.
I can believe that. It's McDonald's.
15?
50.
What are they?
50.
What are they?
50.
What are they?
I don't know. I wish you would tell me. Is it mystery meat?
I feel like I'm at cafeteria.
See if maybe this video can give us a little bit insight on this. Advertisement. I don't like advertisements.
Why do you think Solo's is bad?
We're still on the facts.
I know. You're doing advertisement. I'm trying to make sure we don't have dead air.
No. We're doing the facts still.
What are you doing?
And here's McRib, a little video about McRib, okay, folks? Because I'm... Oh, you have to read it. Well, that was a bust. Anyway, let's go to the next one. What a complete... Okay. The Mummy... Ramadas 2 needed a passport to visit France in 1970. Sounds made up, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Listen to this one. When you receive a kidney transplant, they don't remove your old kidney. They just keep it in your body and gets all absorbed up.
Ew, what?
Gross. Isn't that gross?
What the hell? So what, just leave it in there? Oh, we're just going to leave the spare part.
I feel a little stuffed at the moment down in my kidneys.
There are exactly 2 escalators in the entire state of Wyoming. Now, that to me, that sounds made up. No, you know, because
that's hilarious.
Why is there an escalator in Wyoming? You know?
Yeah.
Why is there only 2?
Why is there one at all? Wait, okay. What? Now, this one I take issue with, but here we go. You guys will know this one. The tallest mountain in the world is in Hawaii.
Yeah, I can believe that.
It's that volcano.
Is that the one that just erupted in Kilauea?
But it's underwater. But you know what? It's not higher. No. Wrong. Okay.
he read the fact and said, nope, that's not true.
No.
This fact's wrong.
Because it's above sea level. That's the measurement they should take, not the highest mountain. Like,
they do elevation.
Mount Everest is the highest mountain above sea level, not from this where it starts. Okay. President John Tyler, you know him, right?
Yep. No.
He was the president.
I think he was the 12th president?
Yes, very good. 10th. but you were wrong. You're in the ballpark. He still has a living grandson. He has two of them.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's pretty neat.
Probably old as fuck.
Well, that's neat.
Now, this one doesn't seem so hard to believe to me.
Wow, that's neat.
Martha Stewart got her start as a model.
I could see that.
Yeah.
I bet she was a hot piece.
Yeah, she was. here we go. Scientists have isolated a bacterium as a contaminant in hairspray. So I guess this microbacteria only lives in hairspray.
I use hairspray.
Who
every
uses
day.
Hairspray anymore? You do?
Every day. Way better than using gel. Way better.
Wow. Huh.
Call me a woman if you want, but it's what I do.
Okay. You're
okay.
a woman.
You're a woman.
You're a woman.
This is a little hard to believe, but the guy who invented the polio vaccine refused to patent it.
Why?
Because he just wanted everyone to have it.
That's what fair. A nice guy.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
But he probably didn't get very much money from it.
He didn't get any money, I'm sure.
But he was famous and he helped other people. And what's wrong with that?
He probably made money somehow.
What's wrong with that, folks?
Well, it's the same guy. It's just like when they brought up the guy that that led gynecology like into the way it is
into
now.
The,
but he was
oh,
but he was the... testing it on slaves.
Oh.
Yeah. They were going to try and take his name off of like some history of medicine kind of thing. Even though
he was testing their little gynecological
yeah,
area.
Even though he pushed gynecology study. Ooh. Like
some of these words have double meanings with what you're talking about.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and take a break, and we'll be back with more. We've had extra news from the Druish, and that's good.
Yep.
But we'll be back with more KCTK Radio's Week Review with Paul and Drew. We'll be right back, and Jack.
Let me go first.
Hi there, I'm Eddie. I live in Jefferson City, and I'm your local pest control mate. I deal with all sorts of pests. Cockroaches, spiders, snails, worms, ants, you name it. Everything. I'll even get rid of your children for you. I have a big basement full of tools that I use to cut up all the pests that I take away from you. I charge special fees for special objects, like your daughter's clothes. I also really love taking your cats and your sons away. Anyways, I live in a white van that has my phone number written in duct tape on it. Phone number being 813-947-8829. Feel free to give me a call, and if you want your pests and or children taken away, I will be glad to do it. Thank you.
Find Eddie's Exterminator in a van down by the river.
Come on, let's go. Texas Ranger has asked me to ask you to have some Wheaties. Yes, have some Wheaties, because it's National Wheaties Week. The week when everybody goes out and buys a box and enjoys a dish of America's famous whole wheat flakes. Start early in National Wheaties Week so you'll have time to buy them and eat them and buy some more and eat some more. It's National Wheaties Week. Remember, it's National Wheaties Week.
Come on, everybody, to the Wheaties party. Eat a lot of Wheaties like the champions do. Dance together, cheek to cheek. This is National Wheaties Week. Eat a lot of Wheaties like the champions do. Wheaties are breakfast of champions.
Hey, what's going on, y'all? It's me, Jerry
the Confetti Man. That's right, Jerry the Confetti Man. You wanna? I have a brand new store that's called the Confetti Craft Company. That's right, the Confetti Craft Company. I will help you make an awesome crafts moment with your, you know, whatever you call it with all the kids. An album. Yeah, that's it. An album. Yeah. I'm going to help you decorate an album. I will help you make stencils. I'll help you, you know, lay out on top of this album. It's going to be fun. So just come on down to Confetti Craft Company in Columbia, Missouri. Okay? See you there.
On Highway 50!
Hey neighbor, what you hauling? We don't know what you're hauling, but you're certainly hauling it with S&G Hauling. We will clean out your buildings, your basements, your garage, brush, apartment units, and even light hauling. We provide free scrap metal pickup and even yard mowing. Hey neighbor, what you hauling? Give us a call at 816-333-5566. That's 936-8949 for G&G Hauling. What you hauling, neighbor?
Do you want to help me move a child? I'm Eddie.
Welcome back to KCTK Radio's Week Review with Paul and Drew. Jack. I'm Paul, not Drew. Sorry about that, folks.
I'm Drew.
Folks, we have, we're known for many things, if you think about it.
Yeah. Yeah, we are.
We're known for our fantastic improv,
our horrible journalism.
Well, first, our improv that just, where you just basically laughed your balls off at the improv.
Yep.
Our journalism, you're right about that. We broke the story that now
the Zodiac Killer
is caught. We did that.
Wait. It's Golden State. Golden State Killer.
Yeah.
Sorry.
And now you just broke the news of the Zodiac Killer.
and Jeff Bezos has a dog.
Yeah, we mentioned that. So we're known for a lot of things, but we're mostly known for our commercial reviews.
Our commercial reviews.
And
are you going to be a parrot?
I'm sorry.
He says at the end?
You know what? You know what, brother? Stupid cousin?
Yeah, what do you...
Let the man talk, okay?
Paul,
I'm so sorry for him. It's just...
There's no excuse. Now, Jack, you actually brought this next one to us.
I hate it so much.
Let me kind of configure the studio a little bit. Drew, I'm sorry.
Happens every time.
A little bit.
Can you see it from there?
Yep.
Okay, cool. We're good. We're good, Paul. You don't need to touch it.
Okay. Now, tell us, before we even see this commercial, I guess it's one you didn't like. Is that right, Jack?
Yeah, it was the Whole Foods commercials.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Do you want to say why you hate it or just want to dive into
it? No, we're going to dive. It's 15 seconds long, okay? So there's not much to analyze. First off, I feel like we should just play it all the way through, then we'll go back.
Okay.
So what's this meat rating system about?
Let me put it this way. Step one is like... Step five is like...
So, step five. Let's get a New York strip and definitely a filet.
Oh, what the hell?
Okay, so
just for the listeners.
Let me just say this. I'm interested in knowing why you hate it, and I hate it so much, too.
because just so you guys can get the scene. The guys at like your local grocery store, get ordering some meat.
Well, he's at Whole Foods, which I guess is a big deal nowadays.
And he's going, hey, what's the meat scale? And this guy goes, instead of saying, well, you know, our number one is kind of like not as fresh meat, or I don't know what the scale is. I don't know how it's made, but I'm going to make this up on top of my head.
Do you know anything about that, Drew? What would be, now, if you were in New Orleans and you're on Bourbon Street, someone asked you about the meat scale, you would think it was something different. But this guy's, this is talking about like fresh food, right?
And he goes, right, yeah. He goes, well, for number one, and he does a small explosion in his hand and goes, poof. And then for number five, it's like, poof.
too
which
explosive.
Is weird.
It's
like too explosive. Exactly how the rating system would have been if I'd been in New Orleans. And that's what the meat rating is.
And you know,
like it's like, and then it's like number five. Like,
and I'd be right. sitting there, and I'd be if I was this guy, this bald dude, this businessman, I'd be going, "What the fuck did you just say to me?"
Yeah.
And let's take even a further step back. What kind of weird guy goes in and asks what another guy, what the meat rating is?
Well, I always...
I mean, wouldn't you just...
Maybe he thought it was like, maybe he's gay. He's like, that's a secret code to get into the back room.
Exactly.
Hey, what's the meat rating? Oh, I'll tell you.
They all have short Chris Harvey haircuts, so I'm assuming they like that sort of thing. But wouldn't you just assume, you know, what's your quality of meat? This is a little more expensive than the other one, so that's better?
Yeah.
So, here, I want to go back to something else here, too, Jack.
What's this
think
meat rating
missed.
System about?
Let me put it this way.
What is this meat rating system about? And he doesn't even explain it.
Exactly. That's why I'd be sitting there. I'd be the bald dude going,
step five, like,
what the hell did you just say to me? What did
you say?
I'd be sitting there. Oh, wait. It's right behind him. Oh.
You just said you'd be the bald guy?
I said,
no, you won't.
No, I said,
you will never be the bald guy.
I said, if I was the bald guy.
No. Take it back.
Never mind. I'm going to throw the bald guy away, and I'm going to put myself in there.
Right, with hair. With plenty of hair. Plenty of hair.
Luscious
that
hair.
That was so close, Jack. I was worried
and
about you.
I'd sit there and go, oh, hey, look. Step 5+. Animal-centered. Entire life on same farm.
Oh, it's like, okay. It's how they kill the animal.
Oh, yeah.
That's great.
So, step 5. Let's get a New York strip. And definitely a filet.
Well, why
look at this guy. A New York strip and definitely filet because I know my meat. I know my meat scale.
You only need one. You're not gonna share with anybody. Yeah. You're eating alone. You sad, bald piece of work.
I think he might be married.
So what's this meat?
I don't see a ring. Oh, I do.
Okay, so let's just go to the ratings. If you guys are ready, I know I've given you enough time to think about it.
Yes.
What do you think? What's your rating?
Zero.
Zero?
Zero. I'll give it a one.
Let me ask you this. When you saw it the first time and you hated it so much, what'd you say?
I said, what?
Oh, you didn't say anything out externally like I usually do with the commercials I hate?
No, we were in the middle of a restaurant. I'd be better to keep those words inside.
Smart.
I just looked and went, what?
Would you give it a one?
Mm-hmm. What about you, Paulie?
Why aren't you answering it?
I'm sorry. I'm going to give it a one. My bad.
Okay.
It's a podcast. They can't see you.
Well, there's also a camera, so I mean, I'm not totally not on camera.
Yeah. I give it a one, too. Okay, so just to show that there are some that we do like, I want to show you this one. This is from Canada.
Oh, we do like this.
And I like it. And it's encouraging men to get prostate checked. I mean, that's a hard thing to do, right?
Yeah. Well, last time I went, you know, the doctor was like, no hands, see?
See, with jokes like that, you're going to like this one. Because it's really encouraging men who aren't very good at taking care of themselves anyway. Although, I just want to announce I do have an appointment with the gastroenterologist. And they're going to do the
camera.
Yeah.
You know, Paul, I really appreciate you telling us this.
Yeah.
But then again, you didn't need to tell us that.
What do you mean? Why not?
Do you need to ask him how you can make it pleasurable for you?
I'm going to get a colonoscopy, and it's going to be a camera.
A Cosby? You're getting a colonoscopy?
No. It's going to be a camera. I'm going to record it. It's going to go up there, and we're going to play it on the podcast. It's going to be our highest rated show.
I'll watch it just for you.
Okay. Here we go. Ready?
Are you just going to click play, or...
Oh, hey, guys. Hey, come on in. Thanks for coming today. If you could all line up for me along the table, that would be great.
Too many men put off getting a prostate exam because they don't like the thought of a doctor's finger going into their rectum. So we're testing the Famous Fingers Collection, a line of latex exam gloves modeled after fingers we think men will like. Let's see how it's going.
So how does everybody feel about Frankenstein?
Oh, surprisingly sensitive. I like it.
Babe Ruth.
Feels like it's all over the place.
I want to like it.
Yes, for me.
Winston Churchill.
Oh, yeah. I like that.
A little sloppy.
Beethoven.
I love his tunes.
Thor.
Ah.
Is that two fingers?
I really like that one.
As our testing continues, we'd love to hear from you. Is there a finger famous enough to get you tested?
What were some of your favorite fingers from today?
I gotta say, it's probably a three-way tie between Babe Ruth, Abraham Lincoln, and whoever this guy is.
The finger you're feeling now is Billy the Kid.
Oh, cool.
Very cool. We thought you'd like that one.
Somebody farted.
Wow. Does anyone have the courage to try Bigfoot?
Well, as long as it's, you know, the hand and not the foot.
I am so disturbed by that question. It's so, it's,
hey, come on in.
Was this on actual TV?
This is from, I think it was a commercial from Canada.
That's literally awesome. That's amazing. I love this.
I thought it was hilarious. What'd you think, Drew?
I think it's funny as shit. Oh, yeah.
Basically, it's welcome to the turning gay session.
They weren't. Who was turning gay? No one's turning gay.
Yeah, but they all liked it.
Realize that if you
do get a hard on,
it's a good thing, right? Otherwise, your prostate's fucked.
You're right.
Oh no!
I just want to make that clear.
So everyone, get your. You know, that's our sixth caller will get a free prostate exam
with
on,
a famous yeah. hand.
Yeah.
And I'm the famous hand and everything, and I'll be glad to help you out with a free prostate exam.
We're
going to
make sure
like
that his nails are cut.
No way, I'm not doing that.
Okay, so I give it a good rating. I don't want to go back to the music. It just seems like too much trouble. But here's an old commercial. So I give it a 10. What'd you give it?
That was pretty 10.
I give it 10.
Okay, here's an old commercial that was so effective that 40 years later, me and my wife still talk about this commercial.
Oh, wow.
Tell me if you guys have ever seen this commercial.
Is it falling and I can't get up?
Yeah, nice try.
I'll have a veal alla vinginzo, please.
What do you remember most about these?
I believe I'll have the prime rib.
I believe I have prime rib.
The food?
I'll have the fried chicken, please.
I think I'll start with the French onions.
Or the comfortable family atmosphere.
All right.
Oh, boy, steady.
The reasonable prices?
Let's have the steak and lobster.
Or maybe just a nice place to fall in love. These, restaurant and lounge, just west of the Blue Ridge.
Oh my God, that's you too!
The steak and lobster.
Or maybe just a nice place to fall in love. These, restaurant and lounge, just west of the Blue Ridge Mall.
So you think that looks like who?
That's totally you too! Oh, yes. My God. Hey, Keith, welcome to the podcast. Thank you for calling. You are actually caller six.
Am I caller number six?
Yes. I'm calling. How'd you know it was him? Yes.
Well,
yes,
caller.
You want a free prostate exam from our very own Kermit.
Yes, and get it all hooked up and everything like that.
I hope his pot's not too high.
Shut up and bend over.
Oh, man.
Better start squealing.
Okay, I don't know how he's going to do it, but congratulations, Keith.
Okay, thank you. Appreciate it. I love being number six caller.
You're the best.
All right. Bye.
And that was our number one fan, everybody.
I'm to make 13K.
Oh, come on. Come on.
Calm down.
Okay, so let's go back to the V's commercial. So you know what? That does look a lot like me and my wife when we were young.
You know why? Because it's probably you guys.
No, I never could afford going to V's. You're getting a McRib and liking it.
Did you get paid? Did you get paid for this?
Dude, that's not me. That isn't me.
Yes, it is.
Do you think it looks like me, Drew?
I can't really tell.
I can say this.
Here. Oh my God, that is. There is no way that's not you and Aunt Nancy. Do you see that?
Huh.
There is no way.
That's actually eerie.
I'm going to tell you that. I'm gonna share this with you, okay? It looks like us. I see it now, but it isn't us.
Ah, that's awesome. You can just say it to you.
But you're missing. You missed the very. I want everyone to be quiet because this is the best part of the commercial. Okay, you ready?
Genius.
Or the comfortable family atmosphere.
Oh, boy, spaghetti.
Oh, boy, spaghetti.
That's going to be a drop next week that I'll be playing quite a bit. Okay, let's go back to see.
To look at you guys.
Just start the whole thing. And you're welcome to go to
V's. I'll have a veal alla vinginzo, please.
What do you remember most about V's?
I believe I'll have the prime rib.
The
food?
I'll have the fried chicken.
He decided not to answer.
I think I'll start with the French onions.
Or the comfortable family atmosphere.
Oh boy, steady.
Oh, my.
Reasonable prices?
Let's have the steak and lobster.
Or maybe just a nice place to fall
in
love.
Wow, Paul and Nancy.
These, restaurant and lounge, just west of the Blue Ridge Mall on 40 Highway.
Dude, I'm seriously. What's so funny about that is I had hair like that.
I know.
And she had hair like that.
Yeah.
You promise that's not you.
I'm beginning to doubt myself. If it's me, I never knew I was in the commercial. Okay? I can't wait to show my watch.
There's no way that's not you, too. That's what...
This will make her day. Okay, wait a minute. Let's take a step back. Do you think that I played it because of that?
Yes.
No, I played it because of the funny voices. Oh, boy, Sketty.
Oh, boy,
Sketty. I'll believe I'll have a prime rap.
I swear that's where I thought you played.
I'll have the Sketty.
Oh, boy, Sketty.
You didn't have $6.50 to spend on your wife for dinner.
Hey, man, no. Those Benedicts are amazing on Sunday.
I didn't. Okay, so that was a good commercial. And, okay, let's just go ahead and say it was me. So, how would you rate this commercial?
I give it a 5 now that I know it's you.
I'll give it a 10.
Thanks, Jack.
I didn't know we had a famous person here.
You know what? You
today.
Know what? You're right. 3.
Fuck you. So, we talk about movies, we review commercials.
We do something like that.
But now is the time where I want to tell you about some movie facts. First, Deadpool. We talked about Deadpool last week.
We did, yeah.
You're going to see it Sunday?
Yeah, are you going?
I'm going tomorrow to see it at 4 o'clock if you guys want to come.
Oh, so you're not cool enough to go with me and Mac.
That's right.
Gotcha.
That's right.
Gotcha.
That's right. So, sorry about that.
Who are you going to see it with?
I'm going with Velvy, Michael, Johnny, Danny.
Oh, cool. So you get to go with all your friends?
No, they're Velvy's kids.
This guy sounds like Jack. What the hell? Freaking douchebag.
So anyway, we're looking forward to that, and we'll get a review of that next week. Would that be okay, Drew? Can you do that? Okay.
I can do that.
I should be able to do that, I think.
Aren't you going?
Oh, you got to work, so you can't go to the thing.
Yeah, I'm working and stuff.
Okay,
so
here's some interesting 20 random movie facts. First of all...
I'm sorry, I'm trying to tighten my microphone. It keeps getting loose. I apologize. There we go. Okay.
This is a boring one. The second act of Moonlight was filmed at New York Giants quarterback Geno Smith's high school.
What? I've never even seen
that. That's the worst one I've ever seen.
I don't even know who Geno Smith is, so okay.
Okay. You guys already know this one. One of the most popular quotes in pop culture is Darth Vader's Luke, I am your father. But here's what the real story is. He actually says, no, I am your father. Did you guys know that?
I did know that.
Yeah, yeah.
Huh.
No.
In the movie Titanic, viewers swooned over Leonardo DiCaprio's Jack Dawson drawing Kate Winslet's naked body, but it really was James Cameron drawing that.
Oh.
The director. That's stupid, too. Okay.
When was this?
Here's a movie fact.
Titanic.
Walt Disney was not a fan of Alfred Hitchcock and wouldn't let him go to Disneyland.
No kidding. That's cool.
That's funny.
That's hilarious.
You guys will dig on this one. Heath Ledger's Joker was one of the best villains in history, if not the best. It's no surprise that he scared Michael Caine to the point that Caine forgot his lines while filming the
One scene in particular is when he comes through the elevator and he looks at Michael Caine. That's when the first time Michael Caine actually saw him on film, and he was like, he literally forgot his lines. He was supposed to say something right there.
See, that's surprising to me because Michael Caine has done everything and been everywhere.
I mean, Heath Ledger was amazing in that movie, so I totally get that.
Sylvester Stallone, he is an advocate for authenticity. When he was filming Rocky IV, he told Dolph Lundgren, God, I can't talk tonight, to actually punch him. And then Michael B. Jordan did the same when he filmed the Rocky spinoff Creed.
That's awesome.
So I wouldn't call that a spinoff. I'd call that a sequel.
You think so?
Yeah. Because it's the same universe, same chapter.
Yeah.
I wouldn't call that a spinoff. That's me, though. Sorry.
Okay.
It's a good movie, though.
I never saw this movie. In The Black Panther, the youngest version of Forrest Whitaker's character is played by Denzel Whitaker, which I guess is related. But despite having the same last name, the two are not related. Okay, see? That's the point of it, I guess.
Huh.
That is a stupid fact that no one cares about.
And they have the same kind of eye.
Now, you guys know the movie Halloween?
Yes.
Have you ever thought that Michael Myers and Captain Kirk look alike?
Oh, it's because they're the same person.
They're the same captain. Because the mask is actually a Captain Kirk mask that they spray painted white.
Yep.
Okay, The Matrix. This is a great movie.
Never seen it.
It's there's three of them.
I'd recommend seeing the first one at least. Okay. Will Smith was offered the job of Neo instead of Keanu Reeves, but turned it down. He has no regrets and thought that he later said he would have messed up The Matrix.
Keanu Reeves is the right way to
Yeah. go. Marlon Wayans almost played Batman's famous sidekick Robin, but was recast when they got a new director for the Batman movie.
Huh.
That would be interesting. This is interesting. Gal Gadot, when she filmed Wonder Woman, she was 5 months pregnant in some of the scenes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Hey. Now, your wife is 5 months pregnant.
Right.
And then some, right?
Right.
How would she like to do a movie?
Probably not.
Okay. the movie Terminator. You guys know about that one, right?
Yes.
Which
never
one?
Never seen it, but yes.
Which one?
Arnold Schwarzenegger was the bad guy in the Terminator, and they almost cast O.J. Simpson. Wouldn't that have been interesting? Yeah.
He would have had to come in the rest of the movies, if that's the case, because they kept reusing Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah.
Dude.
He just ended up killing somebody in real life.
That one scary Mexican actor, like, he was in jail, but then he's like, please, we need this guy for the movie, and then they let him out or something like that.
What's that guy's name? Danny...
We know who...
Oh, Danny Trejo.
Danny Trejo. Yeah.
Wasn't he
I've heard that before.
Yeah. Machete.
Have you guys seen Straight Outta Compton?
Yes. Yep.
So, the star of it is actually Ice Cube's son, O'Shea Jackson.
Yep.
In the film, the younger Jackson...
He waves at himself.
...even got to utter the same phrase as his father did in Friday, by Felicia. That's funny.
Oh, I thought the craziest thing about that movie is that he's playing his dad, and he's waving at a kid that's playing him.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Yeah, if you really think about it, he's waving at himself. It's kind of crazy.
Did you... Okay, in the movie Iron Man, did you know what Jarvis stands for?
No.
Just a rather very intelligent system.
Oh. Cool.
That's stupid.
Okay.
Jarvis is originally a book.
No, this is really stupid. Harry Potter's glasses are iconic. Guess how many he had to try on to find them?
200.
160. That's a dumb one, too. So, the Breakfast Club. Seen that one?
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah.
John Bender is a very beloved character in that. He was like the bad troublemaker guy. That's where they got the name of... From Futurama, Bender.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. God, does this ever stop? Oh, The Lion King. Puma in The Lion King is the first Disney character ever to fart in a Disney movie.
That's funny.
When he was a young warthog.
And then finally, Peter Ostrom has one acting credit. He was Charlie in Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. And after that, he became a veterinarian. Those are 20 facts you didn't care to know. And most of them, I think even I said, oh, they're not very interesting. But that's what we do. We review, and then we give you the facts. And now, tomorrow, you get to walk around and go, did you know that Charlie was only in one movie? And people will say, get out of the break room and go back to work.
Get your coffee and go.
And leave me alone. And... Might I remind you, the injunction against you talking to me is still in place. Oh, goodness. Hey, we're having a great time. I hear a dog upstairs. I don't know if it's one of our mascots, but we're going to take a break because we have to do that. We have to do that now. It is the Week Review with Paul and Drew without Jack. We'll be right back.
Hey, Paul.
Yes, Drew?
I've been having a really hard time lately.
I'm sorry.
You want to know why?
I do.
My erectile dysfunction has really been making things rough.
Oh, no.
My wife feels like it's her fault, but it's not. It's because I'm lacking low T.
Well, Drew, when I had that same problem, I knew that raising my T would make me feel more like a man and satisfy my wife.
That makes sense. And you know what I've done? I've decided to find aces, high tea. That's right. One pill a day will help you get your tea back. That's right. It'll help you with your erectile dysfunction, and it'll make sure to give you whatever you need to make your wife satisfied with aces.
Aces work for me. I have a boner all the time.
That's right, Kermut. Yeah, just go on in. I talk to your doctor and get yourself some Aces High Tea. And so just all of a sudden find it on the website at Aces.
All right, get set, both of you. Here comes the shot. 5 seconds. Countdown.
Little buck, it looks like we're ready. And if all goes as planned, we should land on Mars within 60 days. Just super. The first spaceman to travel into space. Dr. Zeno, the whole world will be watching us today. Just think of it. If we're successful, it'll mean the beginning of a brand new adventure. But we'll never equal before.
13, 12, 11, 13.
It's time to relax, folks, and there's nothing that can relax you more than spa day. When we're done here at the week review, we get in a van driven by Jack, owned by his father, and we go every time to the Clarity Float Spa. We have, well, I guess there's three of us, but we do have what's called a couples massage.
Right.
You enjoy that?
I absolutely enjoy it because they also have some tranquil music.
Mm-hmm.
I also enjoy the seaweed mask I get to wear. It makes my skin glisten. And I make sure that they rub me down like a brisket. It's awesome.
What I like the most is when we all disrobe and we go into the spa together. We compare notes. We compare our reaction from aces. And we feel good about ourselves. So think of us standing there at Clarity Spa, naked, waiting for you to join us. That's Clarity Spa in Columbia, Missouri.
On Highway 13.
Why didn't you invite me and everything like that?
Welcome back to KCTK Radio's Week Review with Paul and Drew and Jack.
And I'm Tom Tucker.
And I'm Tom Tucker. Wait, hold on.
I did that.
I'm Tom Tucker.
I'm Tom Tucker.
Okay.
Go fuck yourself, San Diego.
Looks like Gilly, the official mascot of KCTK Radio, just came in. She was upstairs crying by herself.
Yeah, and I felt like going. I stuck my fingers under the door and she got really pissed when I took them away.
Well, she's gone again, folks.
She's
sorry.
Gone again.
Sorry. It's snowing sideways.
Thanks, Ollie.
Do you guys have any clue at all what the number one single of the 1980s were? Just try to take a guess if you can. You're going to win a big prize if you know.
Is it Band-Aid?
The name of the band.
Band-Aid? Is it called Aid?
It's called Band. It's from Band-Aid. You're right.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Congratulations, Jack.
You really need to take off the sheet.
Tell him what
you... Could have given a motherfucker a chance.
Tell him what you won, Kermit.
You won a prostate exam for me, Kermit. You little bitch.
Okay. So...
Bend over.
So we've been playing the top hits. We played from the 60s, the 70s, and here's the 80s. And this is a Christmas song. Do you know about this song, guys?
Don't know about this song.
It's sad as shit. At Christmas time, God, what movie is this from? We let it light, is it in a movie?
It's no. Christmas time.
In our world of plenty, we can spread a smile of joy. Pull your arms around the
world. This tune's really getting me, though.
Christmas time.
So you got Boy George, that's George Michael, Phil Collins, we'll just keep going here. Duran Duran, Simon Le Bon. Sting. The guy from Kaja Gugu, I think.
And Toto.
I swear that's Ra's al Ghul, but whatever.
Bono, have you heard of him?
No.
Well, you're going to listen to him right now, folks.
What's he at least doing? Well, tonight, thank God it's them instead
of you. So anyway, that's the biggest hit. It was, I don't know, 84 is when it was, and they all got together to raise money to help kids in Africa.
Did they also do Peace Around the World or whatever?
Well, okay, so this is mostly England. And then later, they did a thing called
The World or something like that.
Yeah. It was
Michael Jackson was in it.
Michael Jackson did it, yeah.
Yeah, there was like 30 stars that were involved in it.
What was that called?
I don't remember what it was called. I think even Phil Hartman was even part of it.
Justin Timberlake was there?
No, he was not.
No?
Yes, he was. Look it up.
No, he was not.
No, I'm just kidding. Don't look it up. I was just kidding.
I was kidding.
Look up Jack's a dick. Oh, that showed up right here on Google. It's crazy. Jack is a dick.
It's called We Are the World.
We Are the World, yeah.
It was made in 1985. Probably before Justin was born, you idiot.
But guess what? On the bright side.
And this could be the time. The time when it all went downhill.
85 was a pivotal moment. When we heed
a certain call. In American
history. It's Lionel Richie, isn't it?
There's Michael.
King of Pop.
Anyway, that wasn't the number one hit. It was Feed the World or Christmas Time. Anyway, that's a boring countdown. I can't wait till we're done with this one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't wait for
2000. I'm surprised Queen hasn't been on any of it.
Yeah, well.
Did you guys hear about Bohemian Rhapsody? That movie's
coming
out?
Yeah, it looks awesome.
Yeah, I was going to say, that looks really good.
That guy looks so much like Freddie Mercury. It's awesome.
It really is good.
It looks great. We should all go see it together.
Okay.
Okay.
Any news from the Druge?
Yeah, I got some news here. Let me just bring up my app. MTV is halting production on Catfish amid allegations of sexual misconduct.
Well, well, well.
Look at that. MTV said it is halting production of its popular show, Catfish, following allegations of sexual misconduct from a former participant by staff members on the show.
By staff members?
By staff members.
By a staff member or by, like, they all just took turns?
I guess more multiple staff members. Mm. We take these allegations very seriously, an MTV spokesperson said. We're working with Critical Content, our third-party production company, to conduct a thorough investigation, and we've put a pause on shooting until the investigation is completed. Aisha Morgan, who appeared on Catfish 3 years ago, uploaded two videos to YouTube earlier describing her experiences on the show. In videos, she said that the main guy on the show, who she identified as Jack, repeatedly pursued her, inquiring about her sexuality and trying to convince her otherwise when she said she was a lesbian. Morgan also discussed...
Feel free to keep going.
He put a hand up.
I was hoping she would talk about it, but I guess not.
Who? Who, Jack?
Oh, here we go.
Are these the videos?
She looks like a complete idiot. And I ain't got 13 minutes to talk about this. I want to know.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This video I've actually done 3 times.
What?
I feel like I've been conflicted. For one, this is an easy video. For two, I had so many different opinions in my ear, and I felt like I was being like...
Anyway, I don't believe her. Go ahead.
Okay. Morgan also discussed a separate instance where she said she was sexually assaulted by a female production staffer who she only referred to as Carol. She said the two had been drinking beers and she became significantly inebriated. The producer invited her to her hotel room, claiming she had two beds, but she only had one. And Morgan alleges she woke up with the producer on top of her. Morgan declined to provide additional details about the experience with the assistant.
So the two different people, one man and one woman,
yeah,
abused this woman who's on all over YouTube trying to get YouTube likes and attention.
They're not saying it's the main host of the show, are they?
No, not that I know of. What's the guy's name?
It's saying it starts with an N. Neil? Knee? Knee.
So it's not Jack?
No, his name is not Jack.
So it's probably just some dude from behind the scenes.
Just well, being a guy. Have you ever seen that show before?
Yeah. I find that weird because the whole thing is about finding people who are technically harassing people and believing who that they are somebody that they're not.
But the other thing is one person is harassing and one people are so stupid that they fall for not the harassment, but they think they're someone else. Like, here's a supermodel.
Yeah.
Who's
the
texting
trick.
Me.
The
I've
trick.
We're engaged to be married, but of course I've never met her before, and I don't understand why.
I don't understand.
I better call MTV to have them do it for me.
If you can't have a video chat with the person, they're not real.
Right.
You can have an online relationship. Who cares? But if you can't FaceTime that person and see them and talk to them, just get out.
There could be a thing where these people are so messed up that they're so
socially
alone.
Awkward.
They're socially messed up that people take advantage of them all the time. They could be real victims of MTV. But the TV show is just bullshit anyway. It's all made up, and I can't believe I've even watched one of those episodes. I blame my daughters for having it on. And just, they're so gullible. And then the host, they act like they're really saving somebody.
Right.
And then they try to bring them together. Well, the only reason he lied to you the whole time was because, like, they try to justify this terrible behavior to catfish somebody.
Right, and here's another thing I have a problem with is the fact that, I mean, yes, I'm glad that they're getting some justice for some of these people that have been tricked, but at the same time, you're also ruining people's lives.
Right, but then they act like they're ruining people. They're making fun of gullible people. They're ruining other people, but then they're like acting like they're doing it in such a way that they're bringing people together.
So like on 90,
that's so bullshit.
So on 98.1 the other day, they were talking about scammers, like somehow. 98.1, the radio station.
Radio. I'm on.
Yeah, radio. It's an ancient thing.
Yeah, okay.
So, anyway, they were talking about how...
I'm not familiar. Was this on the Telegraph, too?
No. Okay. It was on this Rolloscope.
Okay.
So, it's not a big deal.
Thanks.
So, the whole thing is, you have to wind it up, this whole thing.
Right.
They were saying that people get calls for scams. Like, apparently, this woman was scammed $2,000. Because the U.S. Marshals called her and said, put $2,000 on a Target gift card and send it in, or we're going to get your assets. I swear to God, really? I would have been like, subpoena me. Are you that fucking stupid?
We get those all the time at work. We had a lady come in. She needed to buy. She was on the phone with the person, uh-huh. And she needed to buy $5,000 worth of iTunes cards. And the guy said, you're going to stay on the phone with me the whole entire time. And if you hang up, I'm going to be waiting for you outside.
Oh, my.
Guy's not even there. The lady would not leave until we called the police and had a policeman drive her home.
Yeah, good.
She was there for like
I'm glad she did
hours.
It. I'm glad she ended up trying to figure out who it was.
Right. But, she's like, I can't believe this has happened to me. And I'm just like, are you that stupid?
It's
you couldn't have been
people.
Like, why don't you subpoena me? Why don't you, let's get the real cops involved. Go ahead and call the local cops. Mm-hmm. Once they come into my house and tell me I need to pay you, then I'll pay you.
Well, some of these people get catfished are sad and... I mean, I feel sorry for him a little bit, but then MTV takes advantage of him too. So, you know, I don't care if MTV's in trouble.
Right.
It's a stupid show anyway, but I also don't believe this person.
Well, not to mention the fact.
I don't believe this person anyway.
These people also getting paid for the show.
Right. They are getting paid.
Right. Yeah, my other thing was, just along those lines, like, honestly, what the hell would the U.S. Marshals need with a gift card from Target?
Huh? Right. That's
like,
right.
Really, you're not thinking clearly
if
just going to let them walk all over you and blackmail you into giving money. That's just, oh, God, it's infuriating. It's like, have some common sense.
Yeah.
Jeez.
I wish you had more money. You could do that with, right?
Yeah.
That's good news. So we'll keep us posted on what happened with that.
I'll look more into it.
Because, and then their press release. we take these things very seriously because we don't know what we'll do with this TV show. No one cares. Yeah. Play some fucking
it's
videos.
Like yeah, why don't you get back to what MTV actually was, yeah. And it was all about the music. Instead, it's all about these reality stupid TV shows. At 6 a.m., they'll show music videos, though.
I heard this, and I can't confirm if it's true or not because I don't watch MTV, and I haven't looked it up, but maybe we should do this, that they won't play Childish Gambino because there's a gun in it.
Yeah, okay. I've seen the music video. Uh-huh. So at one point, there's a guy that comes out and plays
an
acoustic guitar.
I've seen the video because I use YouTube because it's 2018, right?
I love the song.
Right. I think he's saying something, right?
Yeah, it's all a message.
I heard the MTV won't play it because there's a gun in there.
God.
And you know what? Don Glover doesn't care because it's the number one song of the country, probably.
Yeah.
Well, it just shows why these traditional media outlets like 98.1
right.
Screw them too.
Yeah,
they're so phony that people are going to YouTube where they can do it themselves.
Yeah,
iPod or what do we call it? A podcast where they can do it themselves.
Yeah,
and they do it because it's all phony stuff. Like MTV's phony.
Yeah. Superman is here.
Okay, I just needed that. Do anything else, Jack? Jack got some tech news?
Nope.
That's okay. That's all right. We've really done enough. Next week, we look forward to hearing you again. And we end up going longer than I thought again this week. But any last words, folks?
Nope.
I mean, this is how we're ended. We're ended on this.
You know, here's what I hear. I'll put it on a bright note.
Okay.
He doesn't know it yet, but Drew is going to be cut from the show.
That's a cliffhanger, folks. Will Drew be back? We don't know. We can't tell you. We just need you to tune in next week. Thanks for joining us for KCTK Radio's Week Review with Paul and Drew and Jack.
For real? This no one even told me about this.
Thanks, folks.
KCTK Production, produced by Paul Lavoda. If you want more information about this content, then you have some real weirdness going on. You can always check out KCTK Radio on Facebook. Listen to live programs at kctk.radio12345.com. Yes, and that is on the World Wide Web. Thank you.